Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
So as present on the screen, there are three ways to describe the order of reaction. You can apply any one of those and you can predict that what will be the value of X or what will be the value of Y, that is the experimental components which are based on rate law. The first one is isolation method. The second is method of initial rates. And the last is use of integrated rate law. So let us see this one by one, starting with the isolation method. It's a very simple process in which, as we know, that for a reaction we are using both the reactants so as to we get a product. So in this thing, I consider the reaction A plus B, which gives me product. So according to the rate law, I could write it as rate is equals to rate constant K, concentration of reactant A and concentration of reactant B raised to X and raised to Y. These are the experimental components. So as we know that to make or to determine the concentration of reactants raised to value, that is X or Y, we have to keep a value of concentration constant. So how can we do that? Suppose among A and among the concentration B, I take the concentration B in excess. So when I take concentration of B in excess, this means this could give a constant value. For this instance, suppose it gives me a constant value K. So in this case, it gives me a constant value. So therefore, the overall rate of reaction in which B is said to be a constant value, and the rate law can now be changed as rate is equals to K, and since B raised to Y is a constant or it is present in excess, I could write it as K inverse and multiply by A raised to X. So the value of constant into constant will be a constant itself. Therefore, the rate is equals to K double dash into A raised to X. So by this method, we could determine or we could compare it with the rate of the reaction and could determine that what will be the value of X. So once the value of X is been known, we could also determine the value of Y also. I would take this example only, but in a reverse way, which means I've taken the concentration of B is in excess, and now what I'm going to do is now I will keep the concentration of B as it is, and I will now take concentration of A in excess. So let us see what do we get from this. So if I consider concentration of A in excess, then the rate law will be K into K into, since concentration of A is in excess, I could write it as K dash and concentration of B raised to Y. Again, constant into constant will be a constant itself. So therefore, the rate is equals to K double dash, and ultimately I'll get B raised to Y. So this is the relation where I could relate the rate of reaction and the concentration of B raised to Y. So by this help, I could determine the value of Y also. So in this both the methods I have applied a situation where one among the concentration I should take in excess, and hence I could determine the value of x as well as the value of y separately. So in this case the word isolated means we have to keep a reactant as it is while the other reactant in excess. So this will make the reactant which is present in less quantity will now be isolated among the reactant which is present in more quantity. So this method is known as isolation method. So by which we have predicted the value of x and y, and we can also find the order of the overall reaction. So now moving towards the next one. That is methods of initial rates. This is very similar to the earlier isolation method. The only thing we have to do is we have could draw a graph and we could determine that what will be the value of x and what could be the value of y. The same isolation method has been applied in this theory. So let us see how can we do it. Recently we have got to know that for a reaction A plus B, that should give me product. And if in this reactant, I could determine the rate law as rate is equals to k into concentration of a raised to x and b raised to y. So earlier that we have did, suppose if I consider the concentration of b in excess, so therefore a will be isolated. And hence what the rate law that I could get is rate is equals to k into k dash of a into x. So ultimately rate is equals to k double dash a raised to x. So what we have to do is we have to predict a graph of it, and by that help also we could determine that what will be the value of x. So this equation cannot be solved easily, so we have to apply log so as to get a graphical method. So what we are going to do is now we are going to equate it with the help of graph. So apply log on both the side of the equation, we could get, I could name the rate as r. So the equation that I could get is log of r, which is equals to log of k plus log of a raised to x. And in this method I could write it in another way, that is log of r which is equals to log of k, log x raised to n is nothing but n log of x. So I could write this thing as x log of concentration of a. So this whole equation is now very much resemble to the straight line equation as y is equals to mx plus c. So in this method the log r will be on the y axis, log of concentration of a will be on x axis, and the slope will be the positive slope m will be in the form of x, and the constant will be in the form of k. So after getting the equation y is equals to mx plus c, what we are going to do, we have got a value of x, that is experimental component x. But now we could do this for, so, but now we can do this for determining the value of y also. Let us see how. So to determine the value of y, the experimental exponent, what we are going to do, we are now going to take the concentration of A in excess. So let us see what we can do from that. So according to that, if rate is equals to K and concentration of A raised to X, suppose it is present in excess, I could write it as a constant itself, that is K dash. And now in this case, the concentration of B is isolated. So therefore, the rate will be, rate is equals to, I could take the constant value as K double dash into B raised to Y. So by applying the log on the both the side, what we could get is, we could get log of R into, again I could write the whole this equation as Y log of concentration of B plus log of constant, that is I could take it as log of K. So in this thing, the whole, so in this thing, the whole equation is now represented as Y is equals to mx plus c. In this case, again, the y axis will have the log of R, that is log of rate of reaction. The m will be, that is the slope will be the value of y, while on x axis it will be the log of concentration of B, while in this case the constant would be the log of K double dash. So by this way we could determine graphically the exponent x and the order of the exponent y. For this instance, let me show you a graph of it. So this is the graph where the log of R is present on y axis. The log of A or log of B, the determination that we take, suppose if we are taking the log of concentration of A on x axis, we could determine the value of x when concentration of B is in excess. And when we are taking the log of concentration of B, in that case we could determine the value of y, and the concentration of A will be in excess, and ultimately we will get the rate constant will be the same in that the case. So this is how we could determine the value of x with the help of its slope and the value of y with the help of the slope. So this is how we can calculate, or we could determine the value of x and y. Now moving towards the next one, that is so now moving towards the next one, that is use of integrated rate law. How can we determine by the integrated rate law the order of reaction? Suppose we know the rate constant value for the first order reaction as K is equals to 2.303 upon T log to the base 10 of A naught divided by AT. So in this case, we could determine this whole equation in a graphical representation as, so this equation can be written as log of A naught minus log of AT. And now we could write this equation as log of AT will be minus K divided by 2.303 into T minus log of A naught. So by this, galti ho gayi. Plus hona chahiye tha. Yahan pe.
Plus kar do na ye minus. It's not minus. It's plus.
हाँ okay. Okay. एक मैं मुझे सोच रहा था जरा. हाँ ये वहाँ पे चले जाएगा. हाँ बराबर. हाँ. बोलो sorry. So this will be the equation that we would get. So the whole equation is now represented by the straight line graph, that is y is equals to mx plus c. So by the help of this we could determine the value of x also. Suppose if the rate constant that we have got it at every time interval will be the constant, then we could determine that the rate of reaction is for first order reaction. And suppose it is not, then it would not be the first order reaction. So by the help of this integrated rate law, we could only determine whether the reaction is in first order reaction or not, because we are using the formula of the integrated rate law for first order reaction. So at every interval of time, the constant, that is rate constant, should remain constant at every duration. So this is how we could determine the value of x. In this case will be 1, or y in this case will be 1 and x will be 0, as you know it. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have got an idea how to determine the value of x and the value of y with respect to the graph or by using this kind of three methods. So thank you friends for watching this video, and please don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you.